I'm just back down to one of our local.
Way to begin with, yeah?
One of our local walks.
The last time we were out for a walk, the elderberry.
Oh, aye.
It was just flowers, and it's got the berries on
there. Aye, it's got them on there. Mm.
I mean, pick yourself some and put it in there, some wine there.
Aye, some elderberry wine.
Yeah, just a little bit of it.
Because there's a kind of few of the elderberry along here. Oh.
Everything will probably be dying off soon, won't it?
It looks like it's getting a bit rough now, doesn't it, aye?
Still a nice day, like.
Aye. Mm.
It often isn't September, you often get decent weather, isn't it?
Aye. We're just looking for a little while again.
Is that red currant? Is that a red currant bush? I'm not sure, like.
It's big if it is, mate, isn't it?
It looks like it is, though. Aye, but I think...
I'm sure it is.
If you keep them in your garden, you'll keep them doomed, but if they're left to grow, I wouldn't fancy trying it, like, because I'm not sure, but...
Yeah. But, it does look like the currant.
It is, like, even the leaves and that.
There's another one there, man, isn't it? We were on about them earlier on in the year. We did see them, man, didn't we?
I'm sure they are, like, but I'm not sure. I think, that's what I'm saying. I wouldn't like to try them, just in case.
You'd think they would all be gone, the birds. Huh? Especially when they're being edible.
Right, they've still got plenty.
It's the middle of September, isn't it? It's like...
It's getting the eye.
But the weather's actually warm when you're in the wood. There you've got the roan with the red berry on.
The finches like them, didn't they?
The bullfinches, aye.
Because they reckon you can actually, if you get them in there, it's freezing, then you can put them out for the bullfinches.
A lot of people do that, like breed them, because it colour feeds them. Now, how the bullfinches have got the red on them.
Yeah. A lot of finches. Roan jelly out of them, now.
Aye. Wait, it's a big old tree, that one.
Roan jellies, it's just like a kind of jam, isn't it? But
jelly, it's what they call it, a bro. Are these foxglove? No.
There's still the bees there.
Aye, I've just seen that bumblebee thing going in that one. And the flower there.
Mind you, this year in the garden, I left the lavender, I just left the damn wild. And there's a dragonfly, massive one. Just behind, can you see it?
Oh, there it is. Where's it gone? How we land?
Funny old size now, it's a really
damn thing. I'm just wondering if I caught it because the camera was all over the place at the same time. It's later on in the year for them.
Is that something you used to see up there?
No. Not them big huge ones. On the top of the hill, there's a kestrel.
It's just kind of dropped down with the sight. Since you switched the... There it is, aren't it? Back up.
It's come back up again.
I mean, you're still not seeing loads of them. Like, you get sick of the red kites now because you see that many of them.
Yeah, you're seeing them all the time.
The kestrel's still...
They're a nice little bird, aren't they?
Still...
If it's gonna get a little bit closer, it is coming closer, mate.
I might catch a dropping beam or something.
I was driving through Borough the other day, there was one on the side of another fell.
I've seen them up there.
It was actually on the side of the main road and had some of it. I just didn't have the camera with us at the time.
That was one of my favourite films when I was a kid, like Kess.
Aye.
At the time, like, you've probably got a lot of kids going looking for Kestrel's nest trying to
bring one up. It's just circling around on the top there, isn't it? Nice to see. I've got a couple of good little bits of a close up of it. But, anyways, we're on our way up there where the pond is. Up over the top of here. We're down to the pond. We came in through the top way up there, and it's all quite well overgrown at this time of year.
It sort of looks black and like oily looking, because the last time you could see the water pretty clear.
In the spring when all the tadpoles and the frogs.
But it looks like there, it looks all...
I think something's been coming in and out of that port though. Do you know, like, and it's like disturbed the bottom. There's a bit, a lot of sediment in here. It was the runoff off the tip, because all that was a tip up there. That's why this pond was never full of life. It took it years to get clean.
Aye.
Because a pond this size, it should have...
What's that on there? Is that a couple of dragonflies? Is it two?
Aye, I can see them both together. I didn't want to get too close. Hey, that was well spotted.
It is two, aye, it is.
Aye, it's definitely two.
It looks like the mating, because it looks like they've got the back ends kind of joined together.
Aye, they are, they're joined up, aye.
What are these bulrushes? Is that what they call them?
Something like that. But that's an unusual site.
I mean, they're definitely mating, aren't they?
Aye, they're stuck together, aren't
they? They've got like four wings, haven't they?
Aye, four wings, and they're always flat when they're up against them like that. Now, what kind of are they again?
We'll have to look up.
I didn't know the name, because we come across a deep one on the road the other year.
Well, you get a blue something and a...
The blue...
Green something.
I can't remember now. It's not something I was ever into.
Even now the dragonflies.
Definitely, because they sit with the wings flat then.
But it's like I say, when we were kids, we never seen these really
up there, did we? Come to the pond expecting to see not much, and we've seen a dragonfly on the path on the way here, and then...
So, I don't know why you're not going to know either, because you're not going to know when they lay there, build the eggs.
Aye.
Where do they like to lay them?
On the plant, on the rush thing, and I'm sure the rush goes into the water. Yeah. And by the larvae thing that lives in the water for up to four years, doesn't it?
That's what I'm saying.
And it's one of the most vicious predators in the water. The dragonfly larvae. Uh-huh. And they come.
I knew you might now, because at the minute you watch a lot more wildlife.
They come out for them certain like months or something. You know, like they're out just to breed again, not to find a mate and to breed, and then they spend nearly all their life under the water. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I hardly ever watch wildlife.
No, actually,
I mean, me being by yourself, you can have. In my house, it's all Carnation Street in Emmerdale.
I've got the luxury of watching what I want. But that's something quite different. They're actually having a bit of a fight, like, a bit of a struggle there. Didn't have to finish, though.
They're going at it for a long time.
I've moved in quite a bit of close, just to these dragonflies. It's not something you see very often, and there we go, they're finished.
Done
and dusted.
Done and impregnated.
Aye. But that's an unusual sight, I would say.
Wait.
It's probably something what these nature people come up for and didn't even see.
I mean, I've seen the dragonflies.
Oh, you see them all the time, aye? But you never catch them mating, that sort of thing, you know. That's a good one.
Well,
I like
that
when I see stuff like that.
Being made birds, I know, but at least we're seeing something.
Aye. Nice pair of dragonflies. Because they weren't as common up this end of the country, I know that.
I remember seeing them as a kid, like those when I lived in years.
I was watching one program, they reckon sparrowhawks love eating them. Aye, because they catch them in flight, they're a good meal, aren't they?
For the size of a sparrowhawk, though.
I think Kestrel's probably his DNA.
Nah.
They're a good meal.
Yeah, we'll head off there.
Aye, we'll head off, mate. We'll come out of here. Yeah, that's as good as it gets.
Not in this time of year.
Aye, everything's dying off. The birds have like grouped back together to get into warmer climates. Oh, there's another dragon. Is that? I've just heard a coot doing there. There's a dragonfly doing there.
Yeah, right. Aye, it says.
I was going to say it could be the same one, but I didn't think it is. Because we've actually seen one on the path up there, and We've seen these two here, they'll be all over in here. The pond's ideal.
I can see the
coop. I can see it on the water. Just in between the reeds.
I can just see it, like. I mean, you might be able to get it.
I've got it there, aye. It's moving around a little bit like the camera. I've got to remember to bring the tripod with us. Yeah. Even in the winter.
It's like I say, we'll keep getting it in the winter, even if it's once a week. We're not going to get as much as we did in the spring,
aren't we? Oh, no, it's brilliant in the spring. Right, we've got the little grebes on here, the one nesting on here in the spring, weren't there? There was two pairs of coots, little grebes. We filmed all the young chicks on the grebes' back, That's something for other people to look up on, like further back on the videos.
I mean, I like coming with Norton now and all the trees is changing colour, isn't it?
Aye, they change of colour. You see a lot more now because you get all the migrating birds together. The flock together, safety and numbers and all that, to go in further places, and there's knee leaves on the trees, but not as many, so you can see what you're looking for, really, can't you? It's like, yeah, we're looking across there and you can just see leaves. You cannot see the wood for the leaves. Well, cannot see the trees for the leaves. You cannot see the wood for the trees.
That's it, you got it.
I got there. That'll be a footpath for a fox, that one. Is it?
Should we head?
Just on that old tab packer thing there. I just got onto it, but it flew away as quick as I got onto it. I'm sure it was one of the mayfly. Because the dragonflies have the wings all flat, and the mayflies, when they land,
couldn't even see that good.
When the rest of them come straight back, I did catch it on camera. I'll have a good look at the video to see what it is.
I'll have to look stuff up and see what
Because it was a nice coloured one, but it was just sitting on that tarp.
I mean,
tarp,
if you think last month, like about a couple of months ago, it was all the butterflies, wasn't it?
Aye.
We didn't really know that was there,
yet. No. You can hear that little willow wobbler there. Something's chased it or alarmed it.
Probably us.
staying its little alarm, Carl. Or it's targeting another one, there's another one, Carl, and I were there. They do them quick like that, and that's when you know. But all this is a good reserve, it's all fenced in. In places, I think, I don't know, why they fence the pylons in? Unless it's dangerous. There might be bits of potholes or something in there, I don't know. Because this is part of the old tip and all, and it might have sunk in places. There's the old gas plant. It's where they take all the fumes back off the tip. It's all pipeline down to there in the burner. Because on any time you can just see the big flame coming up the chimney. And they just burn a lot. They've built another one up in the, see that one in the top field? That wasn't even there at the beginning of the year.
Right,
we walked one through there. Mm-hmm. That wasn't there.
That.
So they might be thinking about doing something with the gas instead of burning it. Well, when you're thinking that, that's been there for a lot of years. So they could have actually like piped that into the houses at Greenside. You know, like where it's close to you, and just they could have given it away instead of burning it. Realistically, you didn't get enough for free these days. Right, we're back down to the end of the path where we've got the car parked. We didn't see anything on the way back, but we're seeing.
I've seen no type, but I didn't really expect to see out.
Aye. So we're just gonna call it a day.